What is up, everybody? Welcome back. Welcome back to the channel. It's Matt, Maddie, Matthew, Mateo, whatever you want to call me. Welcome to Main Street Fire Rescue. I'm placing this vlog in service right now. This is a little bit of a different introduction here. I'm actually doing this after my vlog here because I got delayed by weather and I didn't want to waste any time. So I'm doing this now. So without wasting much more time, let's get into this here. Welcome to the vlog, everybody. I am heading to SeaWorld Orlando this evening for a very special event, a concert event. And all I'm gonna say is this one is for all of my country western fans, if I have any that watch this channel. More specifically, the 1990s country western fans. More specifically, the 1990s era of country western music. So if I have any fans of that era, this is going to be a treat for you. I am heading to SeaWorld to see the one, the only, Tracy Byrd. I have been wanting to see him for a very long time. Just how things worked over the years, in the last couple decades, I haven't been able to see him. He's one of the few of the great artists from the 90s era that I haven't been able to see live yet. So this is a treat for me. I'm very excited to see this. I'm a big fan of all his music. I have actually his CDs in my car still, in the, you know, little CD holders. I have his album. I think it's called No Ordinary Man, and I have the other one he did. I think it was in the late 90s, early 2000s, called Big Love. He redid that song. I forget who else did that song, but it might have been Chris LeDoux. I think Chris LeDoux did Big Love, and then Tracy Byrd did it again, and both of them sing it phenomenally well. So I can't wait to hear all the songs, like, was it 10 Rounds with Jose Cuervo? What else is in there? Keeper of the Stars, The Watermelon Crawl, all of that stuff. That's such timeless music. So this is a treat. I hope you all enjoy this. I know I'm looking forward to it. As we get into the show, it's not the full show. I got in there about I got in there about 20 minutes late. Again, the weather got really bad here. We had some really severe weather, and it really made travel very difficult. So I waited the weather out and then hightailed it over to SeaWorld. So nice thing is I only missed like two or three songs of the whole show. So I hope you all enjoy this. I love doing this kind of stuff for you all. I hope you enjoy it as well. If you want to see more concert vlogs, let me know. I am in the mecca of concerts here in Central Florida, in Orlando. Especially with all the theme parks nearby, there is never a shortage of concerts to go see. And I'm a big classic rock fan, as you can tell from my other vlogs I've done, especially from the springtime. Last time I went to SeaWorld for a concert was Night Ranger. I think that was late February, early March. And that was a phenomenal show. And that vlog did very well, and it's still doing well. So thank you to everybody who's been watching that and commenting on it. And so this one here, this is actually the last show of the band's Brews and Barbecue summer event for SeaWorld Orlando. Next weekend, hard to believe, kicks off the Halloween Spooktacular weekend for the kids. And the following weekend is Hollow Scream. And then a couple months, we'll be back at the Nautilus Theater for A Wondrous Night, The Greatest Story Never Told, which is one of my all-time favorite Christmas shows, not just in Central Florida, but pretty much anywhere. It is an amazing show. Can't wait to bring that one to you as well. But back to the matter at hand. Outside of classic rock, I am a huge country western fan, which is funny because I never used to like country. All of my years growing up through grade school, junior high, and even high school, I'm like, oh, I don't like country. And I was always big into classic rock. That's what I was raised on. I went to school, when I went off to college down at Vincennes University, down in Vincennes, Indiana, very, very southern Indiana, a lot of my friends that I had made listened to country music. And so I finally just gave it up and went, you know what, fine, I'll listen to it. Because they all said, hey, Matt, just listen to it. Give it a chance. Like, give it a couple months. If you hate it, we'll never ask you to listen to it again, or you know, we'll leave you alone. I said, fine, fair enough. So I started listening to it. I'm like, okay, that was a catchy tune. Let's listen to another one. And another one would come on, because that's what I would do, is when I was doing my drafting work for architecture, I would have the radio on my drafting table. And I know that's before digital era, you know, back in the late 90s, MP3s and that weren't quite there yet. So I loved to listen to the radio. So as I was drawing and working on my projects, I would set the station to a local country channel and then, you know, start listening to music. And I'm like, yeah, that was a good song. Oh, that was a good one too. And so I slowly started becoming a fan of all these guys and gals that sing country music. Long story short, I came home later that year for the summertime, and I'll never forget, I was working on a project, a big summer project. I was building my very first radio-controlled airplane throughout the summer, and when I did that, I was listening to the radio, and I had remember putting the old cassette tapes in the radio, and you hear a good song, and you hit record? Well, that's what I did, and I still have some of those tapes to this day, and they still play. I have a little cassette player. And it's kind of fun to go back through the old memory bank, because it's like you can just see certain things by, you know, hearing the music from that era. So I really, really, really started to become a fan of country music, and I started becoming a fan of all of these artists. And then when the concerts would come around, a lot of us, we'd go see these guys and gals in concert. And, you know, I've been to see George Strait, Tim McGraw, even Chris Ledoux, who's now the late, great Chris Ledoux. He passed away, it's been quite a while. I think it's almost been 20 years now. But I got to see him at the Indiana State Fair once. I've seen, who else? Got to see Trace Adkins, the late, great Toby Keith. Kenny Chesney, who's one of my all-time favorites. And the list goes on and on and on. And now I got to add in Tracy Byrd this evening, so it's awesome. I can't wait to see him. So without wasting any more time, let's get our asses out to SeaWorld so we can see an amazing concert. I just have this idea that it's going to be a phenomenal show. Wink, wink. You all are in for a treat. So I'll see you all for the follow-up vlog after the concert's over. Let's get out to SeaWorld. Enjoy.
original if you've never tried it. It's long. It's through the desert. It gets hot. You get sand in your boots. You get really, really thirsty. I mean, like, crazy thirsty. So thirsty that you might even go 10 rounds with those.
Yeah!
Sent it over to me. He wrote it with Marla Cannon and Michael Goodman, I believe, who wrote it with. But he sent they did a demo on a guitar, just a guitar on like a boom box, and he sent that over to me. And he said, "Man, this is for you." He said, "This got to be a song for you." I said, "I love it." I said, "But there's one problem." He had evidently, I mean, I know he drinks tequila because I've drank it with him. But they had written instead of, at the wind, instead of now I can't even remember what the lyrics are. You know, I kind of only remember when I'm singing them, you know. Anyway, it says down to something there in the end. And they had said, we're down to the worm. And I said, hey, that's a problem. He said, why? I said, because Cuervo don't have a worm in it. I said, you thinking of mezcal? I said, Cuervo don't have a worm in it. And so they went back and fixed it and took the worm out of it. So, but I'm sure if you've had 10 rounds, you don't care if there's a worm there or not. Anyway, Odell sat down his fiddle there, and we're going to pick up that gut string guitar and do a few songs we've had. This one especially back in 1998 was a hit for us. It's called Heaven in My Woman's Eyes.
Sometimes it seems to me
Texas. Say hello to Mr. Tyler Henderson. From the great state of Georgia on the bass guitar, Mr. Timmy Patterson. From Lake Arthur, Louisiana on the steel guitar, Mr. Joe Rogers. Back here on the piano from San Antonio, Texas, Mr. Vernon Imshaw. From Dickinson, Texas, Mr. Chad Ware on lead guitar. Out there from Houston, Texas, Mr. Trevor Schumann running front of house for us, making us sound good. Thank you, Trev. Whew. Man, folks, this is our 9th show in 12 days. And the bus broke down 4 days ago. So since then, we've been on early morning first flight airplanes and packed into a 15-passenger van. And that sounds like a lot of room, but we got like 9 instruments and 14 suitcases to go along with it. But we made it. We made it to SeaWorld on a Sunday evening, and we're so glad we did. There were times it was questionable, but we made it. So we get to go home in the morning, and for the first time, for 2.5 weeks, really the first time we'll have anything over 3 days off in the last 7 weeks. So we're looking forward to it. We love y'all. We really do. And we're glad to be here. But we're ready to go home. Tell you what though, me and this band here, the Bird Dogs, we laid down a track on an old country song that we all love. And we're thinking about doing something with it, maybe putting it out somewhere there for y'all to listen to. But we want to play it for you live this evening. I know a lot of you gonna be singing right along with it because it's just a wonderful song and a lot of you know it. Some of you may not though, but here it is.
I'm
Well, you liked it, I guess. I'm glad to hear that. Tell you what, I want to say another thing about this band I got up here and us as a unit. It is not to put anything else down, but we travel all over the country playing with different bands, and I can promise you and guarantee to you that everything you hear out there is coming live from right up here. Instruments and the vocals. I guess I'm just an old timer. But I just believe if you go to see live music, it should be live music.
Amen to that.
And we just travel around and I listen to some of these groups and I go, wait a minute. I hear like three guitars and I only see one up there. And there's piano and keyboards, but they don't even have a piano player. And that's because they run in these tracks that they run in with the rest of the stuff, and I just don't believe in that. So, I'm proud of the fact we still do it the old-fashioned way, I guess is what I'm saying. And I want you to know that's what you're getting. What you hollering out there?
Make it bold!
Huck, Keeper of the Stars, Watermelon Crawler. Now listen, I said it was gonna be live. I didn't say we was gonna do all those songs. No, listen, I've been doing this 35 years now. And I know that half of you men in here, probably more than half of you, was drug out here by a woman. Yeah, is it true? That's true, you see. When, oh, it's the other way around on that one? Okay, well, occasionally that happens. But I know that if I, in the middle of the show, play Keeper of the Stars, or Watermelon Crawl, your old man's gonna nudge you with his elbow and say, all right, that's the one you want here, let's go. Therefore, those will be at the end of the show. Anyway, hey, I got to go down to Huntsville, Alabama. Speaking of old timers, we went to Huntsville, Alabama last April and played a sold-out show at the arena there with about 25 other country singers. And it was a big celebration. It was called Still Playing Possum. It was a celebration of George Jones's, the 10th anniversary of his passing. And there was a bunch of us down there and they filmed it for PBS. And so you can go home and watch it on YouTube. You can stream it and watch it. It was myself, of course. And Tracy Lawrence, my buddy Tracy Lawrence was there. Trace Atkins was there.
Nice.
Jamie Johnson was there.
Nice.
Brad Paisley was there.
Yeah.
Travis Tritt was there.
Yeah.
Wynonna was there. Tanya Tucker was there. Lori Morgan was there. Elvis was there. It's just some guy dressed like him. No, but anyway, Jelly Roll was there. Me and Jelly hung out all afternoon. And he told me his life story, and I told him mine, and turns out his is a whole lot more interesting. They're going to make a movie about his, I bet, at some point. They won't be doing that about mine. If they do, it'll be a short film, you see. But he is an interesting guy, man. He has been through it all. Good Lord Almighty. He's lucky to be alive. But we had a good visit. He's a really great guy. And he was real nervous about singing George Jones. And I said, why are you nervous about being here? And he said, Mr. Byrd? I said, hold on. I said, that makes me nervous when people call me Mr. Byrd. Call me Tracy. And he said, all right, you can call me Jelly. I said, okay, good. But he said, I'm nervous because I can't sing like George Jones. And I said, son, nobody can sing like George Jones. And George was from my hometown, Vidor, Texas. So we grew up being both proud at times and ashamed at times of George Jones when he was no-showing, you know. And I got to know him real well, and he was a character. Oh, my goodness. But we're going to sing a couple of George Jones songs that we did that night. This one here is called There's Nothing Better Once You've Had the Best. Not a George Jones song, it's a George Strait song. And you'd be right, because George Strait covered it about 15 or 20 years ago and had a big hit on it. But the first time it came out, it was a single for George Jones in 1967. I was 1 year old when this song came out. It's called A Little Bitty Teeny Weeny Thing and called The Love. Thank you. So I tip my hand safe trip home and a happy life till you see us again. Come see us again, all right?
Yes, sir.
How about a little watermelon crawl?
Yeah.
Dancing up in the dark.
Thank y'all.
We're
hosting it now.
Do you need the concert so ready? Just make sure
any concert, man, big or small, these are the fellas that make their money, man. The road crew, holy cow. Oh, that's awesome. The drummer gave this young man his drumsticks. That's incredible. Oh my gosh.
That's a collection.
That is awesome. How cool is that? Man, big shout out to Tracy Byrd's drummer who came out and, well, it wasn't him, but one of the road crew came out and gave this young man Landon his drumsticks. That was awesome. This was such a fantastic concert. Let's go talk about it. Wow, wow, wow. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful night here at SeaWorld Orlando. Well, back to where we started. Holy moly, everybody. What a fantastic show that was. Tracy Byrd. Man, that guy has got a freaking voice. Am I right? You could have played his CD right alongside of his band up there and him singing, and it would sound no different. You know, I think Tracy Byrd's in his, I'm going to say, probably late 50s, almost 60. And, my gosh, the guy hasn't missed a beat. I mean, it's just still sounds as good as ever. His whole band sounded amazing. I mean, it was just unbelievable. And that was, I will say that, I will say this, this is one of the neatest things about all of these older bands is because, as he talked about in there, and I like he threw that in there, you know, he's like, all of our music is 100% real, y'all. You know, there's a lot to be said for that. You know, a lot of bands and everybody now are making, you know, music, but it's all being, you know, made up. You know, like he said, I see four guitars, but only one guitarist, and I hear a piano, but there's no piano. And it's amazing to hear music that is 100% real like that. And I will be the first to say, even if you don't like country music, you're kind of on the fence with it, if you can get out there and see some of these older guys, the old school guys, you'd be, honestly, go out and see them, especially if it's at a place like this where it's not going to be a whole lot of extra money. Like, for example, you know, let's say you visited SeaWorld today, you know, your annual pass holder, or even you're visiting, you got a ticket. Okay, you run in and see the show. It's not quite my thing. No big deal. You're not out that much money, you know. So this is a perfect place to go and see these shows like that. But I'm telling you what, though, even if you have to pay for a ticket, I think you'd be pleasantly surprised going and seeing one of these guys or gals. You know, back in the spring, I went and saw Joe DiMassina at Epcot for the Flower Garden Festival, the Garden Rocks concert series. Same with her. I mean, she was from the 90s. She sounds good as ever. It's amazing how timeless this music is. And I will say this, if you're a fan, you know, get out and see these bands. You know, hopefully they're going to be around with us for a while, but it's just like, this is like anything, you know, when all of this music is gone, it's gone. And so, well, I shouldn't say it's gone, you know, there'll be people that will always cover it, but there's nothing better than hearing it from the individual or individuals that actually created that music. I mean, it is, there's nothing better than that. But what a treat tonight. Man, got to hear Watermelon Crawl. That was what I was waiting for all night. And Keeper of the Stars, I can remember that going all the way back to my college days. You know, we used to, when I was at Vincennes University, down in southern Indiana, I was there for 2 years before Purdue. You know, me and some friends used to go to a bunch of country line dance bars. One, I think, was in Princeton, Indiana, and the other one was in Evansville, Indiana. We used to kind of bounce back and forth. But I can remember hearing the Watermelon Crawl, and there's a country line dance, I believe, that goes to that. And then obviously all the slow dancing to Keeper of the Stars and all the other great 90s country music. And then when I went to Purdue, they had a bar up there called the Neon Cactus, and same thing. Certain nights, it was country western night, they play, you know, Watermelon Crawl and some of those other ones. And at one point, I used to know all these line dances. You know, it was fun. We had a great time doing it. But this made my night to get out here and see this. I almost didn't go. Very similar to the Night Ranger concert, where the weather got really bad and I almost didn't go. I'm like, you know, I'm not gonna be able to get over there. The weather sucks. I'm so glad I braved the weather, because just like Night Ranger, this was 100% worth the trip out here to SeaWorld. My gosh, I love these concerts, man. These are some of the best ever. That's one thing I love about living in Orlando, are all the concerts that are available to see as part of the theme park packaging. I actually prefer the smaller concerts like this. These are great because everybody's just into the music, and the artists can interact a lot more with the crowd. But I mean, even the big concerts, you know, like you're out on the lawn at some of the big amphitheaters, just dancing it up, having a good old time. And I have never had more fun than I have had at most of the country concerts. I mean, they are a blast to go to. I love my classic rock, don't get me wrong. Absolutely love classic rock, was raised on classic rock. But country concerts are where it's at. I freaking love country. That looks awesome against that sunset. One of the greatest B&M coasters right there. There he is, man. Phenomenal show. Phenomenal show. What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Welcome back home. Made it back. It's about 10 p.m. What a phenomenal show. I know I talked for a little bit after the show outside the Nautilus, so I don't want to repeat too much of what I said, but oh my gosh, what an amazing show that was. I will go and see Tracy Byrd again and again and again. As long as he's touring, I will add him to the list of repeat concerts that I want to go to. I had such a good time there. And so many people around me, we were all just having a good time. I'm going to apologize for the camera being a little shaky at times. It's hard to just sit there and film the show and not, like, get into it. I can't. It's very difficult. I had my camera positioned in a place to where I was trying to really minimize the movements. But, you know, sometimes with people moving around and a lot of people change seating, and some people got up and left, so actually I used that to my advantage to slide down a little bit and get a little better shot, because for a while at the beginning of the concert when I got there, there was this guy. He was probably every bit of like 6'4", 6'5", and probably about 350. He was a big dude, and he sat four rows ahead of me, like right in the camera, the sight line that I had for the camera. So I had to maneuver a little bit so I could get right to Tracy Byrd so I'd get a good shot, and then also film the band. I'm a big fan of the steel guitar and fiddle. I cannot tell you how much I love the sound that comes out of those two instruments. And the fellas that he's got playing those two are just spectacular. I don't know about y'all, but I could sit there and listen to a fiddle and a steel guitar for hours and hours and hours. One of my most favorite memories of being a fireman back in Indiana was we had a
we had a firefighter, a paramedic that I worked on the ambulance a lot with, and he was really good at playing the fiddle and the guitar, but he was a master at the fiddle, and he even played in a band that we'd go, our shift would go and see him play on some weekends when he played the local bars. But he would bring his fiddle into the firehouse, and when all our work was done and we were just relaxing in the evening in between calls, he'd get that fiddle out and start playing, and man, I could just sit here for hours and listen to him play. There's something about the music that comes out of a fiddle. There's just something about it. And then you combine that with steel guitar. Oh, my gosh. I do like what Tracy said, though, about, he goes, y'all, our music is 100% real up here and it's not fake. You know, sadly, that's becoming more and more of an issue with, you know, you go to see bands that a lot of the music is just made up. It's created digitally. And what he said wasn't wrong, and I like him, you know, when he talks about, yeah, he goes, I'm just old school, and I kind of feel that way with some, a lot of the things I do, you know. It's sometimes old school is a little bit better than the new school, you know. There's times when new school is better, but for the most parts, man, I'll take old school any day, and that's pretty much anything. It just was better, you know. But he's a good, just good guy, man. I mentioned it while I was doing the post show vlog there in front of the Nautilus Theater, but him and his bandmates and his road crew, just super nice people. And again, I'm gonna say one more time, this is the one thing I love about country music artists and their crews. They just are such down to earth people. And they don't let all of this fame and success go to their head. Like tonight, when Tracy Byrd's drummer had those drumsticks brought out for that little boy Landon. I mean, that just makes you feel good, you know. And I've seen that over and over and over at country music concerts. I've seen it so much, and it makes me happy because, again, that's what it's all about. And as nice as it would be to have some of that memorabilia, I'm glad to see it go to the kids. Because those are memories that they'll create and have forever. You know, apparently that's his first concert ever. You know, I remember my first concert. It was back in the late 80s. My mom got my brother and I tickets to go see the Monkees in concert. Everybody remember the Monkees? I was a big fan of them growing up. And so that was my first ever concert. I will never forget it. I'm glad I was able to bring this to you all tonight. This was just, it was so much fun, so much fun. And again, all the people that were around me, we all had a phenomenal, great time. And again, the young lady with her son there, Landon, that was able to get some of that memorabilia, the set list, and then the drumsticks. I have some of it captured, I believe, on my camera, because it was all happening so fast. That I was trying to, you know, one, I wanted to make sure it was okay to film that, you know. So I asked first, and she's like, oh yeah, absolutely. So, you know, I went ahead and got the camera on, and I tried to film some things with him and some of the stuff he got. So hopefully it came out. If it did, it's going to be in the vlog. If it didn't, then it's a story for me. and it actually happened. I was there. But amazing show. Tracy Byrd, if you see this, I'll be back to see you again. You are outstanding, sir. You sound just like you do on your, I could put the CD in right now, the No Ordinary Man CD, and play Watermelon Crawl, and it'd sound just like it did tonight. And I think that is what is so incredible about all these country music artists and even the classic rock bands, is they, because their music is real, they still sound the same. And I think that is what is so amazing, because it just shows you that all this music is timeless. And I like what Tracy Byrd said when he was talking with Jelly Roll when they did that concert, and Jelly Roll was nervous about singing George Jones songs, and he said, I can't sing George Jones. And Tracy Byrd says, nobody can sing like George Jones, you know. And anybody that's a fan of George Jones, you're in for a treat, because there are some songs that he did or that he covered in the show tonight. So I hope you all enjoy that. So again, I hope you all enjoy this vlog. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for all your subscriptions. Thank you for 500. Now we begin the march to 1,000. Once we hit 1,000, we're going to do something extra special. I'll do the big, the world's tallest sky coaster, or just something. We'll do something fun, something really enjoyable, because 1,000 is a big deal. Have a fantastic evening. Thank you again for watching. I'll see you all tomorrow. Main Street Fire Rescue, out of service. This vlog and all of the music you heard tonight has been the truth, and it's been actual. And I hope for everybody watching out there, it's been mighty satisfactual. I know it was for me tonight. Have a good night, everybody. See you.